So good morning. So today we will be talking about this hard transform. So calculation of the matrix over here is a bit complicated. So please look into the steps carefully. Okay. The first thing is that in the step one, we have to calculate a variable k where the k is given by 2 to the power p plus q minus of 1, and we have to keep this in mind that k will vary in the range of 0 to n minus 1. So if it is say 2 by 2 matrix, your k will vary from 0 and 1, and small n, it is equal to log base 2 n. Okay, small n is log base 2 n, right? Now for the calculation of k, which varies from 0, 1 to n minus 1, we have to first calculate the values of p and q. Okay, now this is the table which will give you the values of p and q when k varies from 0 to 7. Otherwise, by permutation and combination, you can find out this value. Okay. So the main thing is that you have to calculate k, you have to find out p, you have to calculate q in the step one. Okay. In step two, we have to calculate another variable x, where x is equal to small m by capital N, and m varies from 0 to n minus 1. In all the cases, the value of x will vary in the range of 0 and 1. Okay. So if you are having, so m for a 2 by 2 matrix will be 0, 1, and capital N for a 2 by 2 matrix is 2. Okay, so we will be getting two values of x, x equals to 0 by 2 and x equals to 1 by 2. Okay, that you have to remember. Now the main thing comes over here. H0x. Okay, H0x. Now this H0x is always 1 by under root of n. Now this 0, it is basically the k value. Okay, it is basically the k value. So when k equals to 0, we will be getting h of 0. Okay, and it will always be 1 by under root of n. Okay, now for the other values, hk equals to 1 by under root of n, in the first case 2 to the power p by 2, 2 to the power p by 2 for x varying from q minus 1 divided by 2 to the power p to q minus half 2 to the power p. Okay, q minus 1 divided by 2 to the power p to q minus half divided by 2 to the power p. Next is minus 2 to the power p by 2 in the range of, we ended the first limit at q minus of half. It is basically less than this q minus of half. So over here it starts with q minus of half divided by 2 to the power p, and this is inclusive to q 2 to the power p. Okay.
If k is greater than 0, then it's 1 by root n into this
Huh, definitely. Yeah. 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 Okay. So from here we will calculate x equals to 0, 1, 2 to the to up to n minus 1, and k will vary from 0, 1, n minus 1, and in this fashion it will go. Now you have to calculate this H, which is basically the hard transform matrix. Okay. Now let us calculate first the 2 by 2 matrix and 4 by 4 matrix, and then you will be doing the calculating yourself the 8 by 8 matrix. Okay. Now let's go to this thing. So find 2 by 2 R matrix. Okay. We know we are given with capital N equals to 2. Okay. Capital N equals to 2. So from here our n equals to 1, because small n equals to log 2 of n. So log 2 of 2 is nothing but your 1. So small n is equal to 1. Now k, as I said, it will vary from 0 to n minus 1. So the value of k will be 0, 1. Right? Now comes this table. For k equals to 0, my p value is 0, 0. Okay? For k equals to 1, my p value is equal to 0 and my q value is equal to 1. So best way to remember, for an we will go up to 8 point matrix, so the table becomes like this: 0, 0, then 1, 1, then 4 2s. Okay, in p, 0, 0, 1, 1, then 4 2s, and in the q, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 0, 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. You can keep it in this manner. So 0, then 1, then 1, 2, then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So in this fashion you can remember. Otherwise you have to calculate, back calculate. So for when, what should be the value of P and Q, and where you will get, how will you get the K equals to 1. Okay. There is a formula, na? This formula is there, na? K equals to 2 to the power p plus q minus 1. So from here either you have to calculate what is the value of q, or you can directly try to memorize this and try to find out the value of. Rubja, it's coming.
Is it okay if we directly write the value of P and Q from
that? Yeah, definitely. But for the sake of understanding, while you will be doing the numerical, you keep this in mind. So, in our first step, what was our target? Our target was to calculate the value of K, to calculate the value of P, and to calculate the value of Q. And since we are having two values of k, corresponding p and q values we have already calculated over here. The first one is here, when k equals to 0, our p equals to 0 and q equals to 0. Right? Then for k equals to 1, our p equals to 0 and q equals to 1. Right? This much we have got. Now we have to calculate the value of x. Right? Now what is the value of x? We know x equals to m by 2, where m will vary from 0 to 1, and from where it is coming? Because m varies from 0 to n minus 1. Okay? So when we put m equals to 0, we get x equal to 0 by 2, and when we put m equals to 1, we get x equal to 1 by 2. So these two values we will get. right? Clear? Now the second thing, next step is to calculate the matrix. Try to understand what is happening, otherwise you will be lost. Okay, try to understand what is happening. First we have calculated the value of K, P and Q, and then we have calculated the values of X. Okay, so X is equal to M by N, in this case it is 2, and M varies from 0 and 1, so we get two values, 0 by 2 and 1 by 2. Now we have to make the matrix, capital H, which is the Haar matrix, 2 by 2 we have written. Now the row wise population will be X, okay, 0 by 2, 1 by 2, X equal to 0 by 2, X equals to 1 by 2, okay. Then in your this column wise manner, you will be having K values, K equals to 0, K equals to 1, right. So over here we have seen that we have H of K and then X values. So initially what is happening, K is 0 for, so H is 0, H is 0 divided by 2, then H of 1, no sorry, again over here since K is equal, so H of 0, this thing, right. These values are what, these values of H of K into X, of X, not into X, H of K of X, right. So in this row our K is 0, so H of 0, X is 0 by 2, H of 0, X is 1 by 2, understood. Similarly over here, H of 1, 0 by 2, H of 1, 1 by 2, right. Next, H of 0 is equal to 1 by under root of n. ठीक है, this is H of 0, this is H of 0, क्या होगा इन दोनों का वैल्यू, H of 0 of 0 by 2 is equal to H of 0 of 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by root 2. Okay, now the trick key part comes over here, you have to calculate the limits. So what are the limits? When K equals to 1, because you are now left with 1, H of 1 you have to calculate. So when K equals to 1, what was the value of P and Q? P equals to 0, Q equals to 1. So 2 to the power 0. 1. It this should come as 1, okay, at what interval, pardon, yeah, so you put the value of 1, 1 minus 1, 0, Q is 1, so ye pura 0 ho gaya, 0, X less than Q is 1, 0.5, to the P to the power P is 0, so kya hua, 0.5, 0 to less than 0.5, what is the value, 1, so H of 1, 0 by 2, that is 0, kitna hoga in this limit, 1 mein aa raha hai, okay. In this case what will happen, Q is 1 minus R, P is 0, to kya hua, 0.5 X, Q is 1 to the power D to 1, so 0.5 to less than 1, क्या होगा यहाँ पे h1 ऑफ 1 बाई 2 इट इज लेस देन 1 इट फॉल्स इन दिस रेंज सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू माइनस ऑफ 2 टू द पावर p बाई 2 p इज 0 सो माइनस ऑफ 1 अंडरस्टूड हाँ आई एम ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस मैट्रिक्स दिस वैल्यू एंड देन यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट हियर सॉरी दिस 1 बाई रूट 10 विल बी अगेन मल्टीप्लाइड सो दिस विल बी 1 बाई रूट 2 एंड अनदर विल बी माइनस ऑफ 1 बाई रूट 2 Okay, so see, we have calculated this value of 1 by root 2, 1, 1, 1 minus 1. Okay. Next. Again, look into the thing, look into the this 4 by 4 matrix, we will see. Find 4 by 4 Haar matrix. Okay? Here, n equals to, capital N equals to 4, small n, it will be equal to 2, because n of n equals to log 2, log 2, 4. So it is nothing but here 2. So what should be the your k value? Sorry, this is a mistake. It should be k equals to 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. So this k should be this thing. So from here we will be calculating the values of p and q for k equals to 0, k equals to 1, k equals to 2, k equals to 3. So, we have seen k, p equals to 0, q equals to 0, p equals to 0, q equals to 1, p equals to 1, q equals to 1, p equals to 1, q equals to 2. Right? Now, x is equal to m by 4. So, it will vary from 0 to 3. So, 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4. Okay? So, sorry, this is x. So, 0 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, and k equals to 0, 1, 2, 3. So, this thing, how much? This is 1 by root 4. H1, HK, x, find out the values of p and q. Then for h1 is k equals to 1, in that case p equals to 0, q equals to 1. So what is the interval? Q minus 1 to the power p to x of q minus half to the power p. So it comes out to be 0 to half. Then interval q minus half to the p x q to the power p half to less than 1. So h1 0 4 to the power p 0 4 is less than half to the power p 2 to the power p by 2 under root of n equals to 1 by root 4. Similarly in then 1 by 4 sorry this is positive this should be negative there is a mistake so 2 to the power p under root of n 1 by 4 and 1 by under root of 4 then minus of 1 by under root of 4 and h1 equals to minus of 2 to the power p to the p by 2 this is again minus of 1 by root 4 okay So there is some there was some mistake. Please correct over this. Okay. So this is positive, and this is negative. Okay. Because it is less than 1/4 is less than half. Okay. Similarly, when k equals to 2, we have p equals to 1, q equals to 1. Our limit becomes 0 to 1/4 and 1/4 to half. Right? 0 to 4 and 1/4 to half. So over here, we find out root 2 by root 4, and over here minus of root 2 by root 4, and these two terms, this is outside the limit of half. So this becomes 0. The values becomes 0. H2 2/4, H2 3/4, it becomes 0. Then comes k equals to 3, where p equals to 1 and q equals to 2. Right? Over here now, after putting this value, our intervals comes in the range of half to less than 3/4 and 3/4 to less than 1. So if you see H3 0/4, H3 1/4, they do not fall in this interval, so these values will be 0. And then H3 2/4, it will be under root 2 by under root 4, and H3 3/4, it will be minus of under root 2 by under root 4. Okay, so after doing this, we get this value as the what you call this matrix value. Okay, R matrix, and this can be simplified in this manner. Okay, so what are the steps? First, whatever the things are given, we have to calculate k, p, q. This is the first step. Second step, we will be calculating the intervals of k, x, sorry, which is equal to m by capital N, right? Then third is calculate h0x. So h0x is always 1 by under root of n. Then fourth is, using the given formula, you will find out the intervals, and from there you will be calculating the coefficients. Okay. So again, if you look over here, if you do the in this example, we are having this highly correlated image where all the pixels values they appear as it gets the value of 1, and when you get the transformed domain image, you get a significant signal compression, right? So similarly over here also you get the similar thing. See this 0,0 pixel, it gets a significant number, and all other are not very significant, right? So hard transform, it is again this thing. So it is mainly used for the edge detection applications, and it is having when there is uncorrelated noise, so the energy is not that much compressed. So because of that, it is called that it is having poor energy compaction for the images. Okay, and are usually not used, this hard matrix is usually not used for image compression. Okay. For the correlated image, it can be used, but usually for the uncorrelated images, it is not much used. Yeah. Yeah, you can do it.
Sir, but this was the case for most of the transformers.
No, it's we are only working on a small domain basically, right? On a small image, you have to look into the bigger picture basically.
Sir, because which of the transformers has the best energy compaction?
This DCT and all these things I have already given.
DCT and DCT.
Yeah, so it's written so over there. Okay. So thank you.